Okay, so I'm going to use the same information that we had last time for total product and marginal physical product. And I've recopied it a little bit neater. And now we're going to think about, instead of the physical productivity of the different workers, we're going to think about the economic productivity of the different workers. And in that case, we need to know something not just about the actual quantity of output, but what the value of that quantity of output is. So I'm going to add a couple more columns here to my little spreadsheet. And I'm going to think about the total level of revenue, total revenue, at different numbers of workers that I've employed. And I'm going to think about what we call the marginal revenue product. So marginal physical product measures how many actual physical units you added to production. Marginal revenue product measures how much you added to revenue. And remember here, this is all else equal. So we're sort of assuming we have the same amount of, say, land if we're a farm, or the same amount of machines if we're a factory. We're using the same amount of raw materials or inputs. And when you think about something like a factory, that gets a little bit tricky, because pretty obviously, if you increase total production, you must be using more raw materials. But go ahead and let's stick with this for a little while, and we'll consider more complex cases later. So let's say that each unit of output sells for 10 bucks. So if we hire 0 workers and produce 0, our total revenue is, of course, 0. If we hire 1 worker and produce 19 units, our total revenue is 190. If we hire 2 workers and produce 36 units, our total revenue would be 360, and so on and so forth. So 510, and 640, and 750, 840, and 910. Okay, so, you know, just going back to the old, what is total revenue? Total revenue is the amount of output, which we're now calling total product to make sure we don't get it confused with the quantity of labor. Total product times the price, and in this case, I assume the price was 10 bucks. Obviously, if the price was something other than 10 bucks, this whole column would be different. Notice we're also assuming a perfectly competitive firm that can keep on selling more without changing its price. And we can come to more complex cases later, but we'll go ahead and start with that perfectly competitive firm. So, what is each worker's contribution to the actual bottom line? Well, the first worker causes our revenue to be 190 bigger. The second worker causes our revenue to be 170 bigger. The third worker causes our revenue to be 150 bigger. And so on and so forth down this line. And in fact, it's going to be true that in this nice, simple, perfectly competitive case, the marginal revenue product is equal to the marginal physical product times the price of the output. So that's going to make this really easy. We can just take this number and multiply by our $10 output price. Okay, so far so good. We also could compute average revenue product. So that's measuring the average economic productivity of our workers. And for one worker, we had total revenue divided by the quantity of workers, and that gets us $190 of revenue per worker. If we have two workers, and we have 360 of revenue, then we have 180 of revenue per worker, and so on and so forth down the line here. If we have 3 workers and $510 of total revenue, we divide 510 by the quantity of workers to get 170 revenue per worker. I think we get something like this, and even down here to 130. Okay, and again, notice that just as before, the average revenue product was, the average physical product was the average of all the marginals up to that date, so it is also true that the average revenue product is the average of all the marginal revenue products to that point. Okay, so now the question is going to become, which workers is it profitable to hire? And that'll be our next lecture video.